Coming up next, our main event, a matchup for the UFC middleweight division title. So here he is, the number one middleweight contender, getting set for this 185-pound title fight. He believes this title shot should have come a long time ago, but he has let bygones be bygones. The focus now, unseating the champion in dominant fashion and starting a new middleweight legacy of his own, 25 minutes or fewer away from becoming the new champion. We will see how he performs tonight. So here's the undisputed UFC middleweight champion of the world making the walk, looking to defend his title. It is certainly something that he's been able to do in the past. He has been challenged on this title run. It's not as though he has run roughshod through this division, but they're all still chasing him at 185 pounds. Tonight, at least on paper, could be his most difficult challenge to date. Tell the tape for this middleweight championship fight. More than a decade separates these two fighters when it comes to the age. Some differences in height and reach. All right, now for the official introductions, we go inside the octagon to Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. When the action begins, our referee in charge of the octagon, Herb Dean. This is the moment UFC fans around the world have been waiting for. Live from the sold-out arena in Rio de Janeiro, Brazil. It's time! Five rounds for the undisputed UFC middleweight championship of the world. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This man is a wrestler holding a professional record of 18 wins, 9 losses, and 1 no contest. He stands 5 feet 9 inches tall, weighing in at 185 pounds. Fighting out of Yuma, Arizona, USA, introducing the challenger, Kelvin Gastelum. And now, introducing the champion, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a kickboxer, holding a professional record of 12 wins, no losses. He stands 6 feet 3 inches tall, weighing in at 185 pounds. Fighting out of Las Vegas, Nevada, USA, ladies and gentlemen, the reigning, defending UFC middleweight champion, Awesome.
All right, this is for the championship. You can give me your instructions in the dressing room. Protect yourself at all times. Follow my instructions. We will have a clean fight. Touch gloves. Let's make it official.
They touch him up, and we are underway.
Ready. You ready to fight?
So here he is, the reigning, defending, undisputed UFC champion, and what a fight it was for him his last time out, winning the belt by vicious knockout. We're expecting massive pay-per-view buys here tonight, because when you turn in a result...
Oh! He's in trouble. He's hurt bad.
Oh, straight right! Well, perhaps a sign of things to come as he lands a kick there.
Nice kick landed by this gentleman. Dig and kick.
Oh, you can hear the thwack from here as he lands another leg. Oh!
He was perfect. Serves him up. Go get him.
Pretty good work off of the bottom here by Gastelum. Back to the feet now. Gastelum gets touched by that leg kick attempt.
Big punch lands over the top. How's he gonna follow this one?
Smooth Gastelum boxing on full display here, DC. I know he's a collegiate wrestler, a guy who was a grappler. Striking has really improved leaps and bounds. Double leg. Hey, finally gets the takedown. It wasn't for any lack of effort, but finally that shot was good enough to get his opponent down.
I don't know how many times, John, I could have watched this guy shoot takedown attempts without securing one. It's almost like out of pity. You feel good for him to finally get it done. Now what does he do with this top control?
He jumps on a headlock. We call this in wrestling just a headlock. And if you're not careful, you can get stuck in an arm triangle.
Watch triangle, watch triangle.
Nicely done. Crazy accuracy and efficiency with these ground and pound strikes here. And if you're the opponent, you got to intelligently defend or the referee's going
to
stop it.
You got to defend. But you can see him now start to gain posture and the intensity in which he's throwing these ground strikes is starting to improve. It starts to elevate because he knows that he can get the finish. Look at him whip his hip into that kick.
Officially turned a huge head strike to stun his opponent. We'll see which corner can adjust here moving forward.
I mean, they've got to be celebrating. They've got to be happy. Everything's working. But the other side has to be concerned. They have to figure something out, make some sort of adjustment to try to change the tide of this fight.
Right there by Gastelum.
Look at him chopping the wood. Chop the wood with those leg kicks.
Huge strike lands there. Somehow, his opponent stayed upright.
I mean, he's still on his feet, but he's not up by much.
Holding on to him here, not really doing too much. Perhaps just looking to recover. All right, so he's landed some good shots here. Nothing really in terms of combinations tonight.
Well, the jab has been looking great. How about jab, jab, right hand? Right. Because eventually you're going to have to put something on your opponent that's going to really make him pause.
Oh, that is a huge shot right there, DC. You don't want to eat too many more of those.
No, and he needs to start looking to finish now because he's got his opponent hurt very bad.
Oh! Gastelum going for the takedown. Nothing doing there.
It's broken, I think.
The ground and pound going now.
He's putting him in exactly the positions he needs to be in right now. He's able to relax here. And he understands, being a veteran of so many fights, that as long as he's on top, he's winning. He feels like he's winning here.
Well, the ground and pound is there once again. Strong work here by Gastelum. Posturing up now.
And now the damage is about to start. Now the guy's got arm bar. He's attacking it on him. And attacking arm bar. You gotta recognize that when a guy starts to put his feet on your hips, you gotta move them off, and you gotta cover. You can't be off to an angle.
It's in there deep. There you go.
Not tapping out tonight. Ooh, right into side control, DC.
This is where you want to be now because you get to make your opponent decide. They try to turn back into you, you can attack guillotine. If they turn away to try to get to your knees, you throw your hooks in, and you got all your rear choke submissions.
All right, so a huge round for him there. That head kick probably would have had me out for good. The guy survives to see another round.
Yeah, but he'll go back to that. It landed so perfectly. He set it up great. He did a great job of mixing up the target early, going up high, and getting the desired result.
Shot to the body there, really starting to connect at a high percentage now in the latter stages of this fight. And he connects there, DC.
Great job landing that punch.
Oh, level change. Nice trip to get the takedown. Man, isn't it fun to watch this dude work on the mat?
He's unbelievable how fluid he is in his motions on the mat.
Relentless pressure from the top by Gastelum. Beautiful movement, hip work on the ground here, just outstanding with the transition.
He is not staying in one place on the ground, and that's very important.
A lot of top pressure being applied here as he works out of side control. Under 3 minutes now to go in the round. Both fighters get up now. And there comes the separation now. Oh, a nice one. That is exactly how you turn defense into offense. Catches the kick and dumps him on the mat.
What a great job timing that kick, driving into his opponent and putting him on his back.
I love watching this guy move on the ground. Another nice transition there.
Such a high-level grappler. You don't see that very often.
Side control now, DC. A lot of options at his disposal from here. All right, bottom fighter here, maybe looking to hip escape, DC. Oh, he postured up there, gained some valuable separation.
And now the ground and pound starts.
All right, so you got to be careful playing on the ground with this guy. You don't want to mess around for too long. All right, working out of side control here. His opponent trying to control posture, but you got to be careful here.
Now, the guy's attacking the triangle. He finds himself in trouble because he got a little bit lazy in the full guard.
Looks like he's trying to manipulate the head. This could be tight.
Watch triangle, watch triangle. Goes to the finish. Watch his chest go to the mat. He's okay. Now he can escape.
Gastelum going to work here from guard and doing a pretty good job, I might add. Keeping busy here off of his back. Nice offense from the bottom. All right, now we check out some of the action from that previous round, DC. How about the display of striking?
just high level. I mean, you would think that we're watching a K-1 level kickboxing match opposed to being in the UFC. Both displayed great technical skills, unbelievable striking.
All right, so here we go. Fourth round is underway. What is the fighter's mentality when you enter those seminal championship events?
You understand that you are getting close now. The night is almost over. The goal is within reach now. 15 minutes down, 10 to go. You tell yourself you can do anything to hit this. Great punch. Look at him drive his shin into the opponent's body with that body. Hip over when he throws that kick.
Able to check that kick as well. Oh, feints upstairs and lands close to
the knee. Land perfect. That is the reaction you're hoping to get. That one landed perfect in this fight. They will stop very soon. Liver kick. Big, powerful punch lands. Now he gets back to range.
Under 3 minutes now to go in the round. That is a huge shot there, DC. I'm not sure how he stayed upright.
I mean, when you get hit with a shot like that, to stay standing shows and talks to your toughness.
Well, you've got to admire the urgency here. He is trying to keep the judges out of it, lighten up his opponent left and right. Stuffs the takedown, no problem.
Very tricky when he throws that body kick. Level change, leg, finish the takedown. Great job.
All right, he's trying to control posture here. Now trying to hip escape.
He's just trying to move out of this position off the bottom.
Well, you know, I don't like the gi very much, but I have an appreciation and a healthy one for these type of transitions.
You can tell he's been in a gi at some point in his life with the way that he moves. So free.
I'm skipping Jiu Jitsu next week, too. Unable to connect with a right hand. That's it.
He's done.
Well, it's not every day in the UFC that you see a fight ended due to a leg kick, but that one was absolutely devastating. He took away that lead leg of his opponent, who became a one-legged fighter, and then it became just a matter of time. So somewhat anticlimactic here tonight, but not for the winner, as he gets one of the bigger TKO wins of his UFC career. And there is the UFC middleweight champion of the world. He likes the sound of that. And how good was that performance here tonight as he gets the stoppage by TKO?
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Dean is going to stop to this contest at 4 minutes of round number four. Declaring the winner by TKO, and still the undisputed UFC middleweight champion of the world,
So off the record, you'd like the champion to get it done tonight, and that is how it played out, and still UFC middleweight champion. Congratulations, Arnold.
It makes you feel like you know what you're talking about. But in reality, you don't. But this guy makes me feel like a professional because it's hard to bet against him. Sequoia running from a paranoia. Hollywood, I'm never coming, living down in California. I ain't going on like River Phoenix. I want to enjoy all of the spoils. I'm a golden boy like Oscar De La Hoya. I'm a soldier. Dressed up like it's the end of October. Blowing Doja in the streets with Manny Fresh down in the Noya. I done told you. When it comes to beef and I ain't kosher. Bought a Cobra just to keep you snakes closer. I can spy motive. Y'all can try and clone us. Get them lies quoted, but him and I know this. Line of my opponents. Hold the eyes open. Rip out the hearts and let them all die soulless. This step, ride of music. This step, ride of music. East side. This step, ride of music. This step, ride of music. All night when I'm rolling dirty. How many times you gon' play with death before you 30? But I'm chosen, so I'm rolling with 11 on my clothes. It's on a mission.
rich like Danny Ocean, how we roll it. All through traffic with this mob apparatus. These people want me in a casket, still I'm rolling. I heard heaven got a place for me there, but I don't know if I'm going on. I heard them say they want the old gunner. A monster ton coyotes in the road runners. Family, I'll leave your ass with no brothers. It ain't no love when you become a man with no mother. That's what it was, I used to get my ass beat just because. I ran away, hit the trap, they couldn't make me budge. Junior year, my homie selling crack right off the bus. Knew that I wasn't turning back when I got cup charged. It's the territory, y'all don't wanna march. Cemetery full of graves, I can finish what you start. Lost a milli when they sue me for a fight inside a bar. I hope you pussy think of me every time that you see the scars. This ride of music, this ride of music. I'm going on 24/7. I keep my eyes open, ready. All these signs show me they want me gone, like I'm Machiavelli on the cross. And they cross me over, over something so petty. Kill them all, even if I die like Anthony Mendez in belly. I am Gone Kelly. Ain't shit you can tell me. Get me drunk and mad enough. I go pop the trunk of the Chevy. I'm a dad and a savage. This is not an image like Eddie. Rap for currency like I'm Spitter Andretti. I let it fall like a Fetty. Bought for my dogs that they got locked in the celly. Celly. The one that turned on me, I won't ever forget it. You learn it. Your own homies you knew since the beginning. They see you winning and they wanna see you finish. God damn.
We came a long way.
Stop now, you got 30 seconds. All right, great job. I need you to...
They caught me sinning again, yeah.
Timing, reaction, that's the goal today. Great block. Great, let's do another. Perfect. nice punch. You felt that one. Come on, 30 seconds left. Beautiful combination, I love it. Keep it up, put the pressure on it. You know, we could have done a little bit better, but we could have done worse too. Got 30 seconds. Let's go. Stay sharp, kid. That's what I like to see. Volume and precision. Takedowns. What are we doing today? That's right, takedowns. Great sequence of strikes there. Loving that. Man, your next opponent is gonna be no match for you. Okay, beautiful level change. That was wrestling 101. I can see it.
And coming up next, our main event, a matchup for the UFC middleweight division title. All right, so here he is, the inimitable last style bender, Israel Adesanya, still undefeated as a mixed martial artist. DC, you tried to bring him in to emulate John Jones back in the day, and he's such a meticulous, thoughtful guy that he said no because Luke Rockhold was in that gym and he thought he might have to fight him one day.
He knew that at some point he would reach Luke Rockhold in his division, so he said, you know what? I want to help you, DC, but I can't because of what's going to happen going forward in my career. He did not want to put Luke or himself in such an awkward situation. How about forward thinking? How about forward thinking that that would have come to pass only a few short years later? But in Israel Adesanya, you also have the mentality, but the fighting ability to become a UFC champion in only 12, 13 months.
So here he is, the reigning, defending, undisputed UFC middleweight champion of the world. This man ubiquitously regarded as the top 85er at present. Some people believe this is the greatest middleweight of all time. He certainly does, and he has goals even beyond that. He wants to be one of the greatest mixed martial arts athletes of all time, and in order to preserve that goal, this is a title defense, simply put, that he's gotta have. Tell the tape for this middleweight championship fight. Adesanya is 13 years the elder. He is 1 inch taller. He will have a 3-inch reach advantage. All right, now for the particulars, he is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. And when the action begins, our referee in charge of the octagon, Dan Mergliotta. And now, this is the moment UFC fans around the world have been waiting for. Live from the sold-out Bell Center in Montreal, Quebec, Canada, it's time! 5 rounds for the undisputed UFC middleweight championship of the world. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner.
This man is a mixed martial artist, holding a professional record of 27 wins, 3 losses.
He stands 6'4" tall, weighing in at 185 pounds. Introducing the challenger, Israel, the last style bender, Adesanya. And now, introducing the champion, fighting out of the red corner.
This man is a kickboxer, holding a professional record of 13 wins, no losses.
He stands 6'3" tall, weighing in at 185 pounds. Fighting out of Las Vegas, Nevada, presenting the reigning, defending UFC undisputed middleweight champion of the world, awesome.
All right, this is for the UFC championship. I want you to obey my commands at all times, protect yourself at all times. I want a nice, clean, safe fight. Touch gloves, back your corners, come out fighting.
So here we go with this UFC middleweight championship fight. The round one clock is starting to tick. The number one contender believes the champ is right for the picking. The champion has heard that noise in the past, and he has dismissed all challengers. He has defended this title. He has taken on all comers. Now tonight, as he tries to continue this championship run, the focus is on this confident number one contender. We'll see how this fight plays out early.
Nice kick.
all. Vicious kick to the outside of that lead. Whoa!
Oh, he's hurt bad. He's hurt bad, John. He's got to press him. He's got to
press him. Just like that, the fight is over.
He's done. He's done. What a performance.
Yes, sir. It goes into the books as a first-round win by knockout. Near-perfect execution. The technique was absolutely gorgeous. And, again, when you catch a guy early, maybe you're getting him cold before he's had a chance to work up a sweat or even get into the fight a little bit. Those strikes can have a bigger effect, and it certainly did here tonight. We go inside the octagon where Bruce Buffer has the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Dan Rigliotta is going to stop to this contest at 1:10 in the very first round. Declaring the winner by knockout and still the undisputed UFC middleweight champion of the world,
and still the king of the 185-pounders. There he is, the undisputed UFC middleweight champion after the knockout tonight in his title defense. And that's got to feel pretty good. There were a lot of people backing the number one contender coming in here tonight, but he certainly muted all of that noise and then some. The celebration is on in the corner.
When you twist the top of the
monster, you get in my way, I'ma feed you to the monster. I'm normal during the day, but at night turn to a monster. When the moon shines like ice world truckers, I look like a villain out of those blockbusters.
Up to the fire, spit a monster.
Blood on the dance floor, the Louis V carpet.
Fire, up to the fire.
Monster, blood on the dance floor, the Louis V carpet.
If you never gave a damn, raise your hand, cause I'm about to set trip. Vacation plans, I'm on point like my index. So all you will ever get is finger, finger, prostate exam. Damn. How can I have all these fans to perspire like a liar's pants? I'm on fire and I got no plans to retire, and I'm still the man you admire. These chicks are spaz and I only get more handsome and flyer. I got them passing out like what you do when you hand someone flyers.
And what goes around comes around just like the blades on the chainsaw, cause I caught the flag but my dollar stacked right off the bat like a baseball. Like kidding, bitch, I got them racks with so much ease that they call me Diddy, cause I make bands and I call getting cheese a cakewalk. I'm a player, I'm too stingy for share. Won't even lend you an ear, ain't even pretending to care. But I tell a bitch I'm area of Shabaria, Baria, 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 the original Richard Ramirez, Christian Rivera, cause my lyrics never sit well, so they wanna give me the chair. Like a paraplegic, and it's scary, call it Harry Carey, cause every time I'm digging Harry Carey, I'm Merriam Dictionary on, I'm swearing up and down, they can spit, this shit's hilarious. It's time to put these bitches in the obituary column. We wouldn't see eye to eye with a staring problem. Get the shaft like a staring column. Drink a happy pack heat, but it's black ink. You will have to bad beats. See what that means, take a back seat. Take a back to fat beats with a maxi single. Look at my rap sheet. What attracts these people is my gangster bitch like Apache with a catchy cheeto. I stack chips, you better got a half-eaten cheeto. Fill him with the venom and eliminate him. Other words, I'm intimate him. I don't want to hurt him, but I did him in a bodies in a lake, obliterating everything is iterator. Renegade him, hit him, make anybody who want it with the penetrator. Don't nobody want it, but they're gonna get it anyway. I'm beginning to feel like I'm mentally ill. I'm a killer, killer, be killer, killer, be the vanilla gorilla. You're bringing a killer within me, out of me. You don't wanna be the enemy or the demon who in me. I'll be a receiving enemy. What stupidity it'd be? Every bit of me's the epitome of a spitter when I'm in the vicinity. You better duck or you finna be dead the minute you run into me. 100% of you is a fifth of a percent of me. I'm about to finish you, bitch. I'm available. You wanna battle? I'm available. I'm blowing up like an inflatable. I'm undebatable. I'm unavoidable. I'm unevadable. I'm on the toilet bowl. I got a trailer full of money and I'm paid full. I'm not afraid to pull them. Man, stop. Look what I'm planning.
Running, rushing, blood spilling, tears are pouring. It seems the well is never filled. Mentally exhausted, overworking, take another pill. Or to keep the owner of the corporation stacking billions.
These corporations manipulating our daily lives. Got us exasperated, working through all our days and nights. Sacrifice your leisure time to end up at a 9-to-5. I'm working till you are deceased without a single moment for peace.
Never still.
It just keeps rolling down the hill. Nobody.
when they get our food and buy things. We only push a button, we don't even have to try.
Can't even lift an eye away from my phone. Talking to Instagram.
Let's go. Some sweet science. Let's go. Oh, wow. Wow. Yes. That punch damaged. Yes. Let's go. That's it. Come on, 30 seconds. Beautiful combination. I love it. Keep it up. Put the pressure on him. Hey, don't worry about it. That's why it's called training. Smooth, strong. That's what we're doing today. Hey, don't worry about it. That's why it's called training. That's a combo. Let's go. You got 20 seconds. Don't worry about today. There's always tomorrow.
In the party, get the f*** out of my way. 30 got kicked like karate, don't wanna meet the AK. Hey, look at me, 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 look at me now. Kidding me, all of my jewelry cost about 100,000. My enemy never has sympathy, Fergie finna lay him down. Sipping on Hennessy, I'm gonna put in the mouth. Who am I? Trap, no. Hey, look at me, look at me now. Trap,
no. All right, some sweet science. Let's go! Great job! Okay, this is how we train to win the belt. What a bruise, what a bruise. You got 30. Let's go. Strikes together. Here we go. That's how we do it.
All right, coming up next, this highly anticipated matchup for the UFC middleweight division title. So here he is, the number one middleweight contender, getting set for this 185-pound title fight. He believes this title shot should have come a long time ago. But he has let bygones be bygones. The focus now, unseating the champion in dominant fashion and starting a new middleweight legacy of his own. 25 minutes or fewer away from becoming the new champion. We will see how he performs tonight. We'll be right back. So here's the undisputed UFC middleweight champion of the world making the walk, looking to defend his title. It is certainly something that he's been able to do in the past. He has been challenged on this title run. It's not as though he has run roughshod through this division, but they're all still chasing him at 185 pounds. Tonight, at least on paper, could be his most difficult challenge to date. Tale of the tape for this middleweight championship fight. Cannoneer is 19 years the elder. The reach is identical. And now with the official introductions, here is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. And when the action begins, our referee in charge of the octagon, Herb Dean. And now, this is the moment you've all been waiting for. Live from the sold-out Prudential Center in Newark, New Jersey. It's time! 5 rounds for the undisputed UFC Middleweight Championship of the World. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This man is a mixed martial artist, holding a professional record of 20 wins, 6 losses. He stands 5 feet 11 inches tall, weighing in at 185 pounds. Fighting out of Glendale, Arizona, USA, presenting the challenger, Jared the Killer Gorilla. And now introducing the champion, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a kickboxer, holding a professional record of 14 wins, no losses. He stands 6 feet 3 inches tall, weighing in at 185 pounds. Fighting out of Las Vegas, Nevada, presenting the reigning, defending UFC undisputed middleweight champion of the world, Awesome.
All right, this is for the championship. You've been given your instructions in the dressing room. Protect yourself at all times. Follow my instructions. We will have a clean fight. Touch gloves this morning.
All right, so here we go.